Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom with a quick tutorial on how to check the storage space or disk space on a Mac running the new MacOS Ventura with some bonus tips for cleaning it out. Don't worry about taking notes because you'll find a recap of the steps at the end of this video. So let's dive in. It only takes 3 clicks to find this information. From your desktop, click the Apple on the upper left-hand corner of your screen. On the Apple menu, choose the first option about this Mac, and a little window will pop up. If the window is short and wide like this, you haven't updated to Ventura yet. In that case, the process is slightly different, so please use the video linked above instead of this one. But if the About This Mac window looks like this, tall and skinny, you have updated, and you're in the right place. Now click the More Info button right here. That brings up this window, which is the About page in the General section of System Settings. System Settings, formerly known as System Preferences, has the same icon, but as you can see, the layout of the app has changed quite a bit, so it's now more like the Settings app on an iPhone or iPad. On this page is basic information about your computer's hardware, software, and warranty. Now scroll down a bit to find the Storage section. If we blow this up, you can see how much storage space you have in total and how much is free. Storage space is a lot like closet space. You can't let your disk get completely full or the computer won't be able to function properly, just like you can't fill up a closet completely or you won't be able to get into it. On a modern Mac with a newer type of storage called SSD, experts recommend keeping a full 25% of your drive free for optimal functioning. That's a lot of space to leave empty, considering how expensive these drives are, and you can get away with less. But if your drive is starting to get too full, click the Storage Settings button right here. After a moment, you'll see a visual map of what's taking up all that space on your hard drive, and a bunch of recommendations for cleaning it out. I won't take the time to go through every option in detail, but if you want to explore these, each area has a little info button next to it that can help you figure out what to keep and what to discard. As you look down the list, focus on the items listed in gigabytes, GB, first, not the megabytes, MB, because gigabytes are 1,000 megabytes. So these 5+ gigabytes of messages are taking up almost 20 times as much space as the 300 megabytes of music. Text messages aren't very big, so why are they taking up so much space? If you click the info button, you can see that it's the images and videos in my message history that are taking up most of the disk space. This list shows me when they were last accessed, and they're sorted by size, so you can save time by focusing on the largest files at the top. You can even open these to see what they are and decide if you need to keep them, like this video of the bear in my neighbor's backyard, which is fun, but I don't need it. So I can delete it right here, and then click Done to return to the main list. I can definitely delete this iOS backup from my computer. That's a backup of an iPad, which is also backed up to iCloud, so I don't need to store the backup on the computer. This can go. That was easy. And probably my favorite option is the Documents one, because it will immediately show you what the biggest files are that you have saved anywhere on your whole computer, plus what's in the downloads that you can get rid of, any apps that are out of date, so you can clean out very efficiently. Also, if your photos are taking up too much space, check out our video about the great new option in the Photos app to help you find and remove duplicates. So you can use these options periodically to keep your computer cleaned out and running well. One quick note, if a lot of your storage space is taken up by documents like this, you may be tempted to use the Store in iCloud option. That has a lot of advantages and it can free up space on your computer, but remember that as soon as you use up the free 5 gigabytes of storage in iCloud, you start paying for it monthly. And over time, that can add up. So think carefully about using that option. Here's a quick recap of the steps. To check the disk space on a Mac running macOS Ventura, also known as macOS 13 or later, click the Apple menu, choose About This Mac, and then click More Info on the window that appears. Scroll down to the Storage section, and if you're tight for space, click Storage Settings, where you'll find a bunch of useful information and tools for getting rid of all the junk that has accumulated on your computer. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.